Okay, good afternoon. Yes, this is my study. I'm from the Eindhoven University of Technology, and we have a nice picture to start with. So this is our building. So Clotilde, you know where to go to. Many people think Eindhoven is about electrical light, but we also do some daylighting, and that's what I also wanted to express here. To start with, we did a study on the impact of the hospital environment. And most of the time, the hospital environment is for patients. So we want to have a healing environment for patients. But the other fact that we have to take into consideration are the care professionals. Because when we are having a good environment for patients, it also is necessary to have good care professionals. And one of the things important for care professionals is that when we give them a satisfied work condition, that is also a positive effect we can create for the patient as well. There's another thing that's going on currently, and that has to do with the situation, more the societal situation, the fact that we actually are looking at a potential shortage of nurses. So we are all getting older. That means that we also need more nurses. So we need to take that into consideration as well. So I was talking about the job satisfaction, which is also very important in a work environment. And of course, how can we reduce stress in the working conditions? So these are all the studies that we all found on doing that, so on doing such a thing. So there are many things who report the benefits of daylight and view. So we have some studies who report about errors, medication errors, and the relation between daylight. Something about sleep, of course. Something about restoration, and that also has to do with stress in this case, but also on mood. So we found some studies in that respect. And taking into consideration the fact that there are a lot of operating room theaters, and that most of the theaters that we know, they have no daylight. They are windowless, to say. So there's no access to daylight, but also no access to view. So we did a current situation in the Netherlands, so we did a small review on that one. In fact, we had in the Netherlands 108 hospitals, and of all those hospitals, 35% had no windows in their operating room theaters. And of those 978 operating rooms, there were more than half of them, so 55.5%, they had no windows at all. And that's, of course, not too strange, because you want to have an operating room to be isolated from the rest of the environment. So what we actually want to achieve in an operating room, that it is a sterile environment. So we don't want to have any impact coming from outdoors, but potentially might have an impact on the patient's safety and also on the safety of the patient's safety, but also on the health condition of the patient. But still, there are some possibilities in there. So that was at least some interesting information we found in that one. And the aim we had then, because we asked ourselves the question, why are there operating room theaters with a window? And can we get some proof of the necessity of having windows in an operating room? So the aim was to identify the benefits of windows in an operating room related to stress, job satisfaction, vitality, seasonal effectives. So we thought maybe that could also have an impact. And of course, the well-being of operating room theater personnel. So in this case, the nurses. Our focus was not on the patients, but it was definitely on the nurses. We also did some literature review on that one, and we found only a very limited amount of number of studies performed in hospitals, especially about these operating room theaters. So we thought there is some potential in there as well. So what we actually did as a starter, we had an online survey that was among four different hospitals, and in total we had almost 120 responses on that one. The population, so the demographics of that one was that majority, of course, because most of the nurses, they are female, so the larger amount was female. The larger amount was also operating room nurses, so the assistants, and also some anesthetics were there because they're also in an operating room. The average age 42, and the work week, well, the Netherlands is quite famous for having part-time workers, so the work week was around 29 hours. And the questions we posed were about the experience and evaluation of work, so that had to do also with sleep, also with recovery after work, etc. We had questions about the seasonal pattern assessment questionnaire. So do we see some effects of, for example, winter depression, seasonal effects in this case. And we had the activation, deactivation checklist, and that sort of has to do with stress. So how do you perceive stress in your environment? From those hospitals, so we had four hospitals, we could identify four groups, four different hospitals. So there were hospitals who had no windows, so never a view. I put it as view, but also no daylight, so maybe it could be a bit confusing, but when I mean never view, that means no exterior windows in the operating room. The other ones who had always a view. And we had hospitals who had a few operating rooms with a window, exterior window, and other operating rooms without, so they had sometimes an exterior view. So here are some of the results, and I see that what I was already afraid of is in fact happening. So what you can see here on the x-axis is the left one is never an exterior view, the center is sometimes an exterior view, and the right one is always an exterior view. And here on the y-axis you see the scores, and the higher the score, the more negative impact it actually has. So we had some questions, so that consisted of like three, four different questions, and that was combined into one question. So the energy during work, and you see that it was significantly different for the people who had no exterior view and the people who had sometimes an exterior view. Also for the recovery after work, we saw that the people with never an exterior view, they had was more negative perceived than the people who had always an exterior view and also sometimes. Work pleasure was influenced, was impacted by having an exterior window and also a view. The emotional reaction during work, so do you feel depressed, do you feel more energetic or less energetic in this case, that was also impacted by the view. And also the stress. Stress level was also significantly influenced by having a view or not having a view in this case. We also asked them about well-being with an exterior view, about the health, so that's the second one, and the third one is the work performance. When I prepared this, it was visible, so I'm sorry you cannot see what is on the scale, but it was visible when I prepared it. So what I want to explain in this one, so look at the first set, that is about well-being. And the left one is, do you think having working in a room without or with an exterior view, does it have a big or a small impact on your, in this case, well-being? And there you see what I want to explain from this graph, basically, is that the biggest impact people thought it would have, so it's a bit difficult to comprehend, but the biggest influence people thought it would have is working with or without view is the difference between well-being. So there we have like 0.7 point difference in scale, and people think that it has a bit of impact on the work performance and also a bit of impact on the health, but not so much in this case. So basically the highest impact it does have, or people think it has, because that's important to remember, it has on the well-being in this case. I'm sorry you couldn't read the slides on that one. And then we also asked them the question, are you satisfied with the current lighting condition? And there we made a distinction between also the people with and without a view. And there we noticed that the nurses always working in an operating room with windows, they are more satisfied with the lighting condition than the nurses without having windows. And well, not very surprisingly, but the vast majority, so 94% of all the nurses that we interviewed, would like to work in an operating room with external windows, and only 2% without external windows. And there were only, so we're missing a few percent, and they didn't know, they didn't mind, they didn't care about what it, what if it could make an impact or it would change the conditions. So coming to a conclusion already, I don't know. Oh yeah, I'm on schedule, I see. So working in an operation room without windows, so the negative impact, so this is a summary of that one, on the perceived stress, work pleasure, energy during work, emotional reaction during work, and recovery after work. And we found no effect or no difference of impact on the seasonal affective, so the SPAC in this case, nocturnal awakening, so we asked some questions about sleep, and the fatigue during work, so they could not distinguish any difference between between that one and general sleep as well. But sometimes, or what we have to take in mind, of course, people are highly biased, because when you ask the question, do you like to work with daylight or without, the majority of the people say, well, I would like to work with daylight. So that's what we could also see from this these results, at least. So there was at least something to start from, to get an impression of, okay, how is it going there. So the next step that we are now taking is to do a real field study, also among operating room nurses. It's going to be a crossover design. So the same nurses will be working in operating rooms with and without windows and in the same hospital. And we want to assess stress. So then experience sampling method. So every 1-2 hours we ask them the question on a 4 or 5 point scale of 5 point scale, how stressed or how vital are you, or how much energy do you have? We measure, so that's the one in the center, the heart rate variability as a measure for stress. We hope to find something from there, because measuring stress in this way is more about acute stress, and we actually want to measure more about recovery, but at least we want to try. And we want to continuously measure the lights, because of course you, when you're in an operating room, you have a lot of light coming from the lamps over the surgical place itself. So we want to measure how much light are people exposed to, at least address or continue looking at the impact of that one, that we really find something about view or maybe about outdoor lighting. And that's about it, what I wanted to tell you about. So thank you for your attention, and these are the members, and thank you, Samantha, also for some help in the analysis for this one. So thank you.
Thank you, Maria.